All right, so today we're going to talk about error messages. What are error messages and how we could create better error messages. Just like in real life, the digital products that we use are also going to have failures from time to time. And as the creators of those digital products and digital experiences, we will have to understand how to communicate those error messages so the end user, the people that's using our products, would understand exactly how to solve that issue. Because in the user journey, when there is an error message, most often the customer or the users are going to be very frustrated. So we want to solve that frustration with great copy, great design, and want to help our users and our customers to reach their goals and using better communication. Okay, and putting it simply, bad error message is a message that no one understands, probably was written by a developer in your product team that understands the problem, communicates something really quickly, maybe in a string or in the code as a placeholder, and then it just stays there and stick in the product. Maybe 5 years after or 6 years after, you can still see like a really bad error message in your product and no one understands why it's there, and everybody are super judgmental about it, even though it's like old news, but whatever. Anyway, the idea is to identify where we have the error messages in the user journey, understand exactly what is the thing that caused that problem, sign and write it down, and then map all of the different things that can cause an error. And then we have three main rules that we're going to use when writing an error message. The first rule, just say to avoid jargon. A lot of time we use technical terms in our error messages, something that is extremely robotic or crazy, but we need to understand that our end users are not robots. They're real people, and with real people, we create real conversations, even if it means that we need to understand what was the problem, identify it, and then communicate it clearly. So please don't use jargon. That's the first rule. The second rule is to lead to an action. Okay, so now that you identified for the users that they have an issue, we need to help them to solve that problem. We need to lead them to an action, take action. So the next step would be to lead to an action. It can be a button, it could be an actionable term, but at the end of the day, the user wants to know what are the next steps, and if they don't know what are the next steps, they're just going to be extremely frustrated. So we don't want to make our users or customers frustrated, and that's why we're going to lead them to an action. The third thing about error messages, and this is very common in every microcopy or every product writing, but it's just to keep it clear. Make sure that you have clarity in your error message. Make sure that people know exactly what they did wrong, and then exactly what will be the solution for that. If it's going to be too complicated, and the error message is going to be too crazy for them, they're just not going to understand, and then they're just going to leave it, because today a lot of people fight for your users' attention. And if you're not going to help them out and just going to overload their cognitive load with unclarity, they're just going to leave it and use something that is a little bit more intuitive and fun for them. That's about it about error messages. If you have anything else that you want to add about how to create better error messages, please feel free to let me know if you have anything that you want to add about error messages. Remember the three rules: no jargon, lead to an action, and keep it clear. That's about it. Don't forget to subscribe and follow if you want more UX and UX writing nuggets. And I'll see you next time.